What's good, YouTube? It's your boy E back again. And I'm running late as hell today, man. See, one of the main reasons why I don't like to go out to bars and clubs and stuff like that and stay out late night is because it fucks up the next day. Like, I get up so damn late and I got shit to do, and now I'm behind like hell. Now I gotta find a way to get it all done. And that's one of the main reasons why I don't drink, man. Damn, it's hot in here. Like, if I drink and get tipsy that night, the whole next day, like, my body is trying to recover. And I ain't got time for that. Like, I got shit to do. I don't have time to be laid up, feeling lethargic and queasy and everything else. That's why I leave alcohol alone, man. I don't see how y'all do it, man. The alcohol every goddamn weekend, popping up the next day to go to work, and man, hell to the no. My body can't do it, man. I gave that up a long time ago. But anyways, right now, man, it is shit. I think it's like 5:00 p.m. And I was supposed to be at the gym today at 12 p.m. But right now it's 5. You see how far behind I am? And like I said, that's why I don't like to go out, man. I'm going to get some food right now. And then I gotta go take this pre-workout back to Vitamin Shop, because this shit nasty as hell. And then I'ma head straight to the gym, man, to get this workout in. Broiled chicken on, dang, what's the name of that bread? Croissant bread, please.
Mayo, lettuce, and tomato, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Anything else?
That'll be all. The driver's side window to my Mustang don't go down, so I gotta keep opening the door every time I'm at the drive-thru. It's annoying as hell, man. Do you need napkins? Yeah, ho. God damn it, give me my napkins now. Shit. I eat like a goddamn grizzly bear. I need my goddamn napkins. It on burnt though a little bit, but it's still gonna be good though. What y'all know about it? So this little pre-workout I have bought, but I'm about to go trade this in, because this shit, Nitroflex, Gat Sports, hey man, this shit suck ass. Like, the green apple flavor was alright, but I don't know, like, whatever extra ingredients y'all had, like, the shit ain't, it ain't mixed that well, and I don't know, man, this shit was nasty. So I'm going to take this back, and it, like, made me feel lethargic, like, it fucked me up. But anyway, I'm going to take this back and pick something else up, man. I'm gonna see what else I'm gonna get though. Only sucky thing is, this is a big ass bottle, but it only got 20 servings in it. That's the only sucky thing. This shit big as hell. So you know the scooper bot, goddamn, the size of a goddamn cereal bowl, bitch. But shit, I don't plan to be on pre-workout supplements that long anyway. So shit, maybe all I need is these 20 servings. So yeah. Oh shit. Oh shit, bruh, this shit good as fuck. Fruit punch, damn, this bitch good. Oh shit, damn. Hey, I think I done found my pre-workout, man. We'll see if it's good once I get halfway to it. If I'm not feeling it, then that shit ain't good. But if I start feeling it halfway down, Yeah. We in there. For real. No chill. I'm on a pill. No, I'm lying. I ain't on no goddamn pill. I was about to rap something, but shit. Y'all ain't ready for them flames.
So today, again, like I said, it's just like a little introductory week into my, I think I said volume block last time, but it's my strength block. Wait. Yeah, I think it's a strength block. Anyways, I gotta go back and look and see, because again, I'm still new to this powerlifting, but today we just got 265 for 4 sets of 5 reps, so it's gonna be real simple. So since it's gonna be so simple, I'm gonna go ahead and superset that with a back movement. Probably be some pull-ups or something like that, but anyways, yeah. So the reason I like to superset my workout is because, number one, I'm trying to spend the least amount of time in the gym as possible. And number two, I feel like it helps with my endurance. It's nothing worse than being in the gym, working out, and you get tired as hell. Like, you know you have the strength to do it, but your muscles are giving out because they're not conditioned to, you know, do that amount of volume or reps and sets and stuff like that. That sucks. So I like to superset my workout, again, to be in the gym for the least amount of time possible and to condition my muscles and build up that endurance and stuff like that.
Download it.
Well, for right now, I really just do everything on the phone. I really don't upload that to the computer because I don't really need to.
And everybody went out and bought your pie? Shit.
But you in good fucking shape, bro.
Trying to get bigger, man.
I wish it was a place that had that rope. I want to be on that fifth type of shit. Well, your endurance.
Oh, you're talking about
now,
like,
you, when you got that.
You talking about like CrossFit type shit.
Yeah.
Got this Stairmaster. Do this for 20 minutes. Get the fuck out of here, man. Yes. 15 seconds left. And I'm done with this shit. Workout went good, man. My meals are right on time. Workout went pretty good. I did my cardio. I'm feeling damn good right now. Time to go pick up some food, go to school and do some work, man. This Mustang right here, I bought this thing back in January, and I was trying to sell it. I bought it to resell it for a profit. But for whatever reason, nobody wanted to give me the money I was asking for. They was trying to lowball me. So I was like, you know what, fuck it, man. I'm just going to keep the car, which I did. Bought a tag, got insurance and everything like that. But after a week of driving this goddamn car, I realized that this damn thing is a gas guzzler. And so now I'm like, I need to resell this thing, man. I need to try to sell it.
Because within 1 week, I kid you not, I've put $100 in gas in this car, dog. $100 within 1 week. Like a full tank of gas, it takes about $40 to fill up. And that's going to last me 3 days maximum. Max. And so I can't have that. Hell to the gnaw. Fuck that. I ain't got that kind of money. So now I'm looking to resell this damn thing. Hopefully somebody buy it and give me the money I'm asking. If not, I might just have to fuck around and take a loss.
Sheesh. So I just went to Qdoba. I think that's how you pronounce it. Got a little bowl, brown rice, black beans, chicken, some of that tomato stuff. I forgot what it's called, and a little bit of queso, just so the junk won't be real dry. But that's what I got, man. This is what I'm snacking on. So what's up right now? It's about 12 o'clock at night, and I'm just now finishing up studying my anatomy. And so last week, we had our first gross anatomy practical or exam. And pretty much the average for the class was like a 55-60%. So like the whole class did horrible. And so now the goal for me is not to complain about how difficult the practical was. My goal now is to pretty much try to stay a week ahead, you know, so whatever we learning this upcoming week, I need to have already finished learning it, you know what I'm saying, by, you know, before class starts. So that's my goal. So that's why I'm here now, doing some of it. I'm not finished, but I've been here for about 2 hours already, and man, I'm tired, man. I'm trying to get home. And so pretty much I feel like if I can stay a week ahead and learn what I need to learn, I feel like I'd be somewhat okay. But the only sucky thing is that studying this anatomy book, everything is color-coded. But when you go and see an actual cadaver,
everything looks the same. And I know, oh, let me clarify this. Every time I say cadaver, a lot of people don't know exactly what I'm talking about. A cadaver is pretty much a dead body, a dead person who donated their body to science. So that's pretty much all it is. So when we're cutting open the bodies and stuff like that, nothing in the body is color coordinated. So everything is the same colors, all the same. So you might be in a book looking at, you know, the different arteries or nerves and stuff like that. But when you get to the body, all the arteries, nerves, and veins, everything look the same. It's all the same color. So nothing is color coordinated, and it's kind of, it's confusing and it's annoying at the same time. So the only thing I can do is study and learn what I can from the book. And so when I get to class and we're doing the dissecting, I can be like, okay, so on the gallbladder, the such and such artery, the cystic artery, wraps around the gallbladder, and you know, it branches off into this and that artery and blah, 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 blah. Y'all catch my drift. But pretty much, man, that's the goal, man. I can't sit here and complain about, you know, how difficult the practical was, what they should have did right, what they did wrong, the length of time, all that. Because honestly, truth be told, if I was more prepared and if everybody in the class was better prepared, like if we studied like we were supposed to study, then that practical should have been no problem, man. But unfortunately, nobody really did that well. I mean, you probably had a couple people who did pretty good on the practical, but most people, they didn't do well at all. The class is only 2 times a week, but in order to get an A on the next practical, I know that I have to go inside that lab 5 days a week and spend at least 2 hours outside of the normal class hours in order to learn everything and get everything packed down. Because just going twice a week, and so I feel like in order for me to do well, I'm going to have to at least put 15, 20 hours in every week in that cadaver lab. And pretty much that's what I'm going to do, man. I'm about to get the hell up out of here, man. My bad, man. My girlfriend had done called me and messed up my video, but anyways, I'm about to end this video, man, because I'm about to go home. I'm tired as hell. Appreciate y'all for tuning in. Go ahead and like the video. Share the video. Subscribe. Do all that good shit, man. But anyways, man, y'all stay tuned for more videos. I'm out.